What if Roberto Luongo was chosen as the starter in the Heritage Classic against Ottawa in 2014 instead of Eddie Lack? What would have happened if Luongo played the game instead of Lack? What would have happened if John Tortorella chose Luongo instead of Lack? Well, that's a good question, and I want to try and pick away at that today. But before that, we have to get into some context. In the early 2010s, post-2011 Stanley Cup Finals, the Vancouver Canucks had a goalie controversy between Roberto Luongo and Corey Schneider. Luongo was the seasoned vet, the one who'd been with the team for a long time. He's the one who dedicated so much to the Canucks, and Schneider was the hot new American young goaltender who was coming up, and he looked like he was going to be such a bright star. These were two top goalies, one team, and one of these dudes needed to be moved. It really looked like it was going to be Luongo, as there was such a strong, fickle attitude from the fans. Everybody hated on the dude when the Canucks lost, and everyone loved him when the Canucks won. He was basically the scapegoat for all Canucks' misfortunes when it comes to things like blowouts, the Stanley Cup Finals loss. There are many boos mixed in with the Lou chant, and for the most part, a lot of people saw Luongo as the sole reason the Canucks lost in 2011, despite the fact that the Canucks only managed 8 goals in 7 games. Now, we get ourselves into the 2013 draft. Luongo is expecting to be traded. Everyone's expecting a trade. Everyone, all the Canucks fans are going into this draft saying, okay guys, by the end of today, Luongo's 12-year contract with a base salary of $6.7 million with a no-trade clause, it's finally going to belong to some other team, and we're going to have Schneider. He's going to be our number one. Luongo's going to be done, and he's not going to be here at the end of the day. But instead, Gary Bettman gets up there and he says that Vancouver trades goaltender Corey Schneider to the New Jersey Devils for the 9th overall pick. This turned out to be Bo Horvat. Now, everyone's shocked. Everyone's thinking, wait, we just got rid of Schneider. That means that Luongo is the number one. And, you know, in hindsight, this was a good trade for us because we have Bo Horvat now. But at the same time, we traded Schneider for this one pick. I mean, I'm not going to be the one over here saying, yeah, we should have gotten more. But I mean, the Canucks did reportedly turn down an offer from Edmonton for the 7th overall pick, a top prospect, and a backup goalie. Whoever that backup goalie was going to be, let's say Victor Faust or Richard Bachman, whoever Edmonton had at the time, who knows? Now, we get ourselves Bo Horvat, he's in our system. Eddie Lack is now the new guy who's come up, and Luongo is still here. It's the 2013-14 season, and Manitoba Moose, or Chicago Wolves, goaltender Eddie Lack, 26-year-old rookie, he's on the team now. This is the Tortorella year, and Lack and Luongo, these two are the guys. For the most part, starting out the 2013-14 season, it was okay. I mean, we were fine. December, oh gosh, December was fantastic. The Canucks went 10-1-2 in December, carried by great goaltending from both Lack and Luongo, and strong players. The Sedins were good. Kessler was good. Higgins had 17 goals in this season. Garrison was also really good as well. This was a good team carried by good goaltending. The fans, these guys love Lack. They love Luongo. Lack's got such a good personality. He's a great guy. Luongo's playing nicely. Everybody's thinking, yep, the Canucks are a good team. We went 10-1-2 in this month, and it's great. By the end of the calendar year, you know, we've got such a strong record. Now, of course, September to December was pretty good. December was fantastic. January to the end of the season, well, we went 13-24-4. It was pretty bad. And the highlight of this stretch from January to the end of the season, the highlights were the losing streaks. And we had a lot of losing streaks, which really demoralized the team. Up until the point where we're here at the NHL 2014 Heritage Classic, and Roberto Luongo gets benched. John Tortorella chooses to start Eddie Lack over Luongo. He cites Lack's strong play since the Olympics, 1-goal games, 2-goal games, shutouts against St. Louis, and he says that Eddie Lack, well, he's giving us the best opportunity to get 2 points against Ottawa, here in the BC Place, in front of 50,000 fans. So, this very anticipated game, in a huge stadium with a lot of people watching, it's a grand game. This is the game where there's supposed to be snow. There wasn't snow. It's Vancouver. There's no snow here. This was the game that was going to be huge. This was the special edition game. And the special edition game did not have Vancouver Canucks' big name goaltender starting. They had Eddie Lack start instead. So, yeah, that's what happened. The Canucks are leading this game, 2-0. Luongo's still on the bench, and Eddie Lack ends up letting in 3 unanswered goals with a total of 25 saves over 28 shots. I mean, it's okay. It's okay. An empty net goal is added on top of that. The Canucks lose in front of 50,000 fans, 4-2. And this game, I might have talked about it, and I just talked about it now in the past few minutes. Doesn't really sound that bad. But I remember watching this game, and I remember the fans being very upset. I was upset with the way the Canucks played in this game. They scored 2 goals. I don't even think they were good goals. I remember making a remark about this game saying that Kessler was the only dude who looked like he wanted the win. Everybody else was kind of trash. How they ended up getting 2 goals is beyond me, but this game at the Heritage Classic was a disappointment. The fans were upset. Luongo was upset. In the post-game, John Tortorella, he's like, yeah, well, Lack was the better decision. And after this, everyone's kind of got a bad feeling in the stomach, and all of a sudden, 2 days later, Roberto Luongo is traded to the Florida Panthers for Jacob Markstrom, Sean Mathias, and I believe a pick. Now, going over to an interview that happened in 2015, Roberto Luongo implies that if he had played this Heritage Classic game, he would still be a member of the Canucks at the time of the interview. So I'm trying to propose a question, what if he did play that game? What if Luongo started over Lack? It's safe to say that Lack would not have started the next 16 games straight after the Heritage Classic, and counting the games before the Heritage Classic, Lack started a total of 19 straight games. The Canucks, after the Heritage Classic, they went 8-10-1. 9 points out of a playoff spot, 7 points out of being the best team not in the playoffs for the Western Conference, as the Coyotes, well, they had 89 points. The Canucks lost games like 6-1 against Dallas, 7-4 against New York, and many more 4-goal games. 7-4 New York was a game where Lack let in 4 goals in just over 5 minutes at the start of the third after the Canucks started the period up 3-0. At the end of the calendar year, at the end of 2013, the Canucks were 23-11-7. As I mentioned, a strong run at the end of December. That was a fantastic December for the Vancouver Canucks, 10-1-2. And the end of the year comes along and the Canucks are a total 36-35-11. From 23-11-7 to 36-35-11. Let's say Luongo stayed with the Canucks until the end of the 2014 season. Realistically, the games like the 4-3 regulation loss, these games against Tampa and Washington, 4-3, these could have gone to overtime with potentially less goals scored against Vancouver. The games like 7-4 loss against New York, 6-1 against Dallas, 5-1 against Anaheim, these losses might not have been as bad. And realistically, if you take a look at the record post-Heritage Classic, maybe even include the Heritage Classic, considering Luongo could have played in that game, realistically, the Canucks could have gotten at most about 5 or 6 extra points. And taking a look at this record, after the trade, the Canucks was also a huge just embodiment of demoralization. The whole locker room was shook by this trade, and there was such a bad decline in motivation after this trade. So if we're taking a look at a no-trade scenario, we're taking a look at a scenario where Luongo was playing in that game and there was no trade afterwards, we could have seen happier players and stronger play because of that. Let's say the Canucks get 5 extra points, maybe another win or so, and some other games that went to OT. That means the Canucks will have finished the season with 88 points, tied for 19th in the league with Nashville, Ottawa, New Jersey. In the West, we would have jumped Winnipeg and would have tied with Nashville. Now that's not playoff worthy, because Arizona, they got 89 and they didn't make the playoffs that year. The Canucks could have gotten close, but there's something else that would have come out of this situation. I don't want to just imply I'm thinking about playoffs. The Canucks wouldn't have made the playoffs that year, but if we're in this situation, they were close. If the Canucks did finish 19th in the league, with a few more points in their repertoire, their draft spot gets dropped down. Now, the teams that were in the ballpark, in the standings of a hypothetical Vancouver Canucks team with 88 points, these are teams like Nashville, Winnipeg, Ottawa. These teams drafted in the 9-12 range. And the question has to be asked, would Jake Virtanen have dropped that far? Who the Canucks would have gotten is beyond me, because they would have been in the running for players like Perlini, Richie Fiala, Dylan Larkin, Julius Honka. Who would the Canucks have gotten? Would they have made the playoffs? We don't know. Would they have taken Virtanen? If not, who would have taken Virtanen? Would teams like Carolina, Toronto, or Winnipeg have Virtanen? We might even still have ended up with him if we got the 9th overall pick. The reason I say this is because, well, Carolina, Toronto, and Winnipeg, they were really sold on the players they got. If we dropped to 9th overall, at best, would we still have gotten Virtanen? What if we got up to 10th overall, or 11th? That's the huge jumble of scenarios when you take a look at the draft lottery and the standings and what the Canucks could have done if we still had Luongo at the end of that season. How long would have Luongo stayed on the team? Would we have signed Ryan Miller? Luongo probably would have stayed for another year or two. That's what I think. And if he gets traded along the line, which is most likely because his contract and age is getting up there, what would we have gotten back? Because we wouldn't have been forced to make a trade like we were 2 days after the Heritage Classic. The return would have been much better because we would have more freedom in discussing trade partners and return. Overall return would have been improved if we just were able to trade him later. And because of this, so many questions that we have to ask. What would have happened with the playoff picture? What would have happened with the draft? What would have happened with the return we received for Luongo? And because of this, it's such a strong notion that John Tortorella's Heritage Classic game decision really did change the direction of the Canucks, and we're still feeling it today. We got Jacob Markstrom. He's our guy now. We got him in the trade for Luongo. What if that Luongo trade doesn't happen that day? He plays with us some more. What does the team look like today? Do we still have Virtanen? Who else do we have instead? Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Plus, you guys are like last year, I was saying gaming. And bye.